Hello friends, and in this video we are going to see, okay, as you can see, we are going to see the problem B. So first of all, I will explain the problem statement. The problem is same parity summons. Okay, so first of all, as usual, I will explain the problem statement, and after that we will move on to the approach and then the solution. So it says that it has two integers n and k. N represent the sum and the k represent the positive integers, number of positive integers I have today. So basically, let's have examples. Suppose the number is n is this and k is this. Okay, so what I wanted is actually I want to break this number n into three numbers so that either all are odd, either all are even, and the number of numbers in which I am about to break are 3. So I have to break this number n to 3 numbers, and either all of them are odd, either all of them are even. And if it is not possible, then print no. If it is possible, then print yes and print all these breaking numbers. So if I want to break in 3 numbers, it states that the answer will be 4 to 4. Now you will think how. So yeah, let me move through it. First of all, I have my n. Okay, so what I am thinking is that n to break in 3 numbers, so n by 3. Okay, so how it goes, it goes 3 times and 1 is the remainder. So actually I will get 3 3 and 3, these 3 numbers, because see, 3 and 3 times 1 is remainder, so I will add 1 in one of these. Okay, now as Aryan, you said that all of them should be even or odd, even or odd, but here as you can see that 1 is even and the next are odd. But actually what I wanted is that see, 1 will always be added because I always wanted my sum to be equal to n, so the remainder will always be added, so it will not change. But I can change these. But how? See, I want these even and these both are odd. So what I will do, I will minus 1 from here and plus 1 from here. Now it has become what? It has become all even. Now let's have another example. Suppose 104. Okay, so 104. Now you will say, see, 100 by 4, it goes 25, so I will write 25 4 times, and these all are odd and the remainder is 0, so nothing to worry. Yes, yeah, nothing to worry, it's cool. So let's move to next example. 97 upon 2, what we get? 48, and what is the remainder? So what will happen basically is that we will write 48, but one will add it to one of the quotient here, so it will become 49. So actually only remaining element is 1. So what the intuition I am having is that the remaining element was 1 only. If it had been 2, then I could have made it 47 and I could have made it 49, but it is not possible here. Okay, so the basic intuition which I am having is that here, if the number of remaining numbers are odd, okay, and suppose after adding my remainder to it, it becomes even and it is odd, or it is odd, it is even, and the number of numbers are odd. Understanding? See, if you're not understanding it, then please listen to the words carefully. Okay, if the number is odd and it is even, okay, or it is even and it is odd, and the number of these numbers, remaining numbers, are odd, so it means that answer will always be no, because you will not be able to change the from even to odd or from odd to even. Okay, so for better example, let's move to another examples. Okay, so For example, I guess you can see 8. It is visible. Let me zoom a bit. Now I guess it is visible. Yeah. So 8 and 8. Okay. So 8 by 8. Okay. It's 1 and remainder is 0. So I will write 1 8 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, it is fine. It works as I told you. Now let's have an example. 3 and 10. See, whatsoever you do, you will not be able to divide 3 into 10 numbers, because actually I want all these numbers to be positive. So whenever n is less than k, answer will always be no. So one case from here. Now let's see 5 and 3. So 5 by 3, it stays 1 and remainder is 2. So 1 I will write 3 times. 1, 1 and 1. I will add 2 to one of the remainders, which makes it 3. Now it is odd and the question was also odd. So answer will be yes. I have to change nothing. Let's see up till now. So the basic intuition which I am having up till now is that I will have my n by k. Okay. Then I will divide it and find my quotient and find my remainder. The quotient states the particular number appears these k times. This particular number appears these k times. Okay. And in one of these, the remainder will be added. So the remaining these numbers, which is quotient minus, sorry, which is k minus 1, these number of remaining, all these values are filled with these quotient. Okay. Now at last I want to check that if it is odd, then it should be odd. If it is even, then it should be even. Then answer is yes. But if it is odd and if it is even, then I will check if these number, which is k minus 1, if it is even, then I can redistribute it and I will redistribute it by adding plus 1 and minus 1. Okay. But if it is not, means if this k minus 1 is basically odd, then I will not be able to redistribute it. So what I will finally do, I will print no. So I guess that you got the basic if else steps. So I will very quickly move you through the code. So yeah, here you go. Let's have t, number of cases. Then I have my first condition, as I said, that if n is less than k, then print no. As I said that if n mod k equal to 0, which means like the case when 8 by 8, or you can see here. So I will just print these numbers. Okay. Else, if n mod k is not equal to 0, means you get some remainder basically. Then what I will check is that if both are even, then okay, answer is yes. As I showed you that if both these groups are even, when I add a remainder to one of them and the remaining div, and if both are odd, then also it's okay. But if we get something like the one is odd and the another is not, so I will check if the remaining elements, which is the k minus 1 elements, if they are odd, then answer will always be no. But if they are even, then what I will do, then I will rearrange it by adding minus 1 and plus 1, so that odd will become even and even will become odd. And one condition for if my remainder is 1, sorry, if my quotient is 1, then I will not be able to subtract 1 from it, which I am doing here, because actually I want my element bigger than 0. So if the remainder, if the quotient comes 1 and the condition here follows, so yeah, answer will be no. So I guess that you guys understood it. So it was basically the you see the all the cases and check what could be the possible solution. So I guess that you guys enjoyed it, and yeah, See you in the next video. Tell me pretty lies, look me in the face, tell me that you love.